Hey everybody, back with part two. So, like I said, you know, that wasn't really a factor with him. You know, sex wasn't like this really, really big, huge issue. It was a part of his life. It was part of everyone's life. But it wasn't something that he dwelled upon 24 hours, almost 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, like most people. You know, there were some people who their whole world basically revolves around sex or trying to get sex or making sure that they have somebody so they can have, you know, sex with that person. And that was not Michael's thoughts. Those weren't his feelings. Only when he was in a very serious, committed relationship. And as I said before, I truly understand that because I had the same feeling. And he, if I'm not mistaken, he kept his virginity until very late in his life. And I did the same thing. Most people keep their virginity when they were, they get into about high school, maybe college, but 9 times out of 10, it's high school. He was somebody who waited until, I guess he was about like in his 30s. He, you know, probably didn't really lose his virginity until after he got married. If he lost it all. Who knows? Maybe he did, maybe he didn't. I say if he did manage to get lucky, hey, good for him. If he didn't, well, hey, that's a nice too. And that means that he went out of the world just as pure and innocent as he came in. But let's face it, he was just a pure and innocent guy at heart anyway. No matter what his physical body did, he was very pure at heart. As far as my sexuality, my virginity, and all that kind of stuff goes, I'm not going to speak anymore about that. I'm not going to say when or if or what the hell ever. All I will say is that, like Michael, I did too, keep myself pure until, you know, I was well into adulthood. And I don't suggest everybody live the way I do, the way I did. But I do believe that if you are going to seriously contemplate thinking about having sex with somebody, that you should really wait until you're with someone that you really truly love and that you really truly care about, and someone that you want to at least spend the rest of your life with, or if not spend the rest of your life with, at least for the next few years of your life. You know, you don't want to be with some, you don't want to give yourself over to somebody and then have them not appreciate you. And I think that's where Michael's head was. I know it's definitely where my head was, is. My thoughts and feelings was, I want someone to appreciate me. That's what I wanted. And I think that's what Michael wanted too. He wanted someone who truly appreciated him as a person. Not just as Michael the entertainer, Michael the superstar. I think he wanted someone who really could see him as a person and as a friend and as a normal human being. I think that's what he really wanted. Let's see, what else is there? There was other stuff that I was going to say, but I can't truly remember. It'll come to me at some point. But yeah, that's what I really think that he really wanted. He wanted someone to really appreciate him as a friend. And as far as the kids is concerned, they were the ones who really did appreciate him. You know, adults, they just want to bask in his light. You know, they wanted the money and the fame and the glitz and the power and all that kind of stuff. And friends, all they really, you know, kids, all they really want to do is just play and have fun. And I can understand that, because he's like a big overgrown kid in some ways. But, you know, with people, you're going to get all kinds of stuff. And like he said in those words. It was so scary that he was coming across people who was always using him all the time. And I guess he felt that that's why he really couldn't make any friends, because people were just, you know, out to get whatever it is that they wanted, you know. They didn't really want his friendship. They wanted everything else that was around him. And that's lonely. That's very lonely when you think about it. Poor guy. So, let's see. There was something else I wanted to talk about, but, let's see. I covered the whole issue of, oh, I remember what it was. The whole reason why I wanted to go into the entertainment industry. I wanted to go in because, not just because I really love performing. That's definitely where my heart is. But I wanted to go into performing, and I wanted to be in the entertainment industry because I really wanted to meet him. And I thought that this was going to happen. I thought that eventually I was going to, you know, that if I worked hard enough and I really, really tried my best, that eventually we would travel in the same circles and that we would meet each other and become friends. And, yeah, when I was younger, I had that thought of, oh, I'm going to grow up, I'm going to be rich and famous, and I'm going to marry him and have his kids and all that kind of stuff. You know, I'm like any other teenager who thought that. But I really did think that as time went on, that I was going to meet him, that I was really going to meet him, and I was really going to become his friend. Because I just felt that he really, really needed one. And as far as myself, I felt that I needed one too. I really needed my own friend. And I thought that maybe, you know, as time went on, maybe the two of us would meet each other and we'd become friends. But sadly, unfortunately, that was just not meant to be. Well, it can happen here in this world. But you'll never know what may happen in the next. Let's see. My keychain. In case anybody noticed, my keychain is a little bit different. I had to get a new one. Had to make a new one. Because someone got some incredibly sticky fingers one day, and they took my keychain. Go figure. I mean, dude, if you wanted one, I would have made you one. You didn't have to take it. And I mean, there's a picture on the back of my boyfriend. I don't even know what you're going to do with that. But I mean, hey, if you just had to have some reason to take it, well, fine. Enjoy. I got a new one anyway. let's see. As far as the anniversary goes, I don't know what I'm going to do just yet. I want to do something. I haven't figured out what. But whatever it is, I'm going to do my best to make sure I bring it to you guys this coming June 25th, 2010. Now, I have one more video that I need to make. And this is going to be a special video to one of my YouTube friends. And unfortunately, for now, this video that I'm going to make is going to be private. For my own personal reasons, it just needs to be private. So, I guess you're just gonna have to, like, keep subbing me or adding me or whatever in order to get to that private video. Because there's a little bit of controversy behind it. And, if this clip, and if the other clips start getting bigger and bigger, and if I start getting more views, I mean, my views are kind of really low right now. But eventually, when my views get up, I'll take and I will make that video open to everyone. So, I'll be back in a couple of minutes. And, in case you don't get to see that private video, let me just be the first to say right now, smile, even though your heart is aching. Bye-bye.